the story of my life. I take her home, I drive all night to keep her warm. In time is frozen.
Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Alan. Yeah guys, so just talking about today, I haven't done a video in about a week, I think. The last time I did a video for you guys was before my birthday, which was on the 25th of April, my birthday was, which was a Saturday, and I put up a video on the 24th, I think it was. So I've kind of had a little bit of a week away, I think. And I haven't done a video for you guys. A few things have been going on, so I just thought I'd come on today and have a quick chat about that, and how I've been feeling about things, how I've been feeling about my Still and World journey, and about what I've come to a decision about that, and different changes I've made about my Still and World journey. So I just wanted to kind of come on and talk to you about that and the reasons why I've come to this decision and different decisions. So I've written down a few things. As you can see probably here, I have a list, and I'll go off that list as I go on, just so I don't forget what I'm going to say to you guys. So the first thing is, I didn't want to kind of make a video about my health. I know that in some of my videos I talk about my health and how it can affect my Still and World journey, or how it can just affect me in general and stuff like that. So first of all, a little bit about my health. My health, as I said before in I think it was my last video, about I couldn't get my Botox because the lockdown came, the country came on lockdown, and I couldn't get my Botox. And my leg has been kind of on my left side, especially my leg has been in a bit of pain since then. My hand has been in a bit of pain as well, but my leg has been in, I think, more pain than my hand, or my arm, or whatever you want to call it. So because I haven't had my Botox, my leg's been getting a bit worse. There has been good days and there have been bad days with the pain. Where to the point now is that with my leg, I'm actually starting to walk straight back up on my toes, which so basically my toes will go up, and so I'm walking on the tips of my toes, or my toes are actually going underneath me. So basically when I have my leg, my foot in my shoe, my toes are curled up like in a kind of a ball. So I'm basically walking on basically the other part of my leg. So basically if this was my foot, I'm kind of walking on this part of my foot, which means that anytime I walk, I have a lot of cuts on my foot, when I walk, they kind of it kind of cuts me and I kind of bleed all the time, which sounds a bit gross and a bit strange, but it just means that it's very painful. Even though I do have kind of bandages on my toes and stuff to help with the pain when I'm walking, it still is very, very painful to do, which means what means is that when I do my body magic that I'm trying to do each day, get out for my one day of exercise, when I try to do my body magic, I can't do as much as I want to do. So I have basically some days I go out for my body magic and I bring Boris out. Boris Monster, which is actually at the moment, he's been very, very good. He's actually in his bed asleep. So basically I try and bring Boris out. It's not every day that I can actually do that. I try and do some body magic in the house, but it depends on how painful my leg is and stuff like that. So that's where my health is at the moment, which kind of leads me into my Still and World kind of decisions and journey and stuff like that. So what I have kind of been doing with my Still and World journey is I'm still staying on plan as much as I can. I've realized that I may have been kind of gone out of plan. I have my ups and down days, and when I do have a down day, I know that I may eat something that I shouldn't eat, which just does happen. So basically I think it was like a few kind of probably about a few months ago, I actually hit my 6 stone award, 6 stone target, and I got my 6 stone award, and I was really happy with that, and I was really chuffed, and it was a great achievement. And then I think it was like, you know, a few weeks after that, I actually changed my target to get to a 6.5 stone award. And when I started on that other part of my journey to get to my 6.5 stone award, my weight was kind of coming down, and then I was going up a few pounds and down, and then I was kind of getting back to kind of losing weight, which was pretty good, and I was getting there. And then the lockdown happened, and then things have been kind of going up and down since then, which means, like, you know, my weight has been going up, and then my weight has been going down. So I've kind of been yo-yoing, as I think we all know about yo-yoing and, on Slimming World. Sometimes these things happen, and I've noticed that because of the lockdown and because of the pain in my leg, and for me, is the healthy eating plan of Slimming World works, and I've no doubt that it doesn't work, because I've lost a lot of weight on that plan and doing the plan. But with me is, when I do my body magic and when I can kind of exercise more often and keep myself active on doing things with my body magic, I know that my weight comes down, and it kind of, for me, maybe not for everybody, but for me, it kind of, it's like part and parcel of the Slimming World plan, healthy eating plan. For me anyway, when I do my body magic at a point where I can do it a lot, it helps me with the plan. Even though I have lost weight with not doing a lot of body magic and just following the plan as I try and do every day, so it's been working. But as I said, I've been kind of yo-yoing, and I've kind of come to a decision about what I was going to do about that. And so let you know, guys, on the, I had my birthday, as I said, on the 25th of April, which was a Saturday, and I got weighed in on the 27th of April. And I had to maintain, and I was pretty happy with having to maintain. But the way it is at the moment, because we're doing our Zoom groups, and my Zoom group is on a Monday at 9:30 on a Monday, so we kind of weigh ourselves in on the Sunday. So I have my birthday, let's say, on the 25th of April, and then I weigh myself in the next day, and I had to maintain. So I was happy with that maintain, but I also knew that maybe because the way of the food I've had for my birthday and the drink I had for my birthday probably wouldn't have caught up on me until maybe later on in the week. So I kind of had a feeling in my mind that I would actually have a gain, or have a lot of a gain. So on the pardon me for having some tea and stuff, but I'm gonna read it out here. So on the third, the Monday after the third of May, when I got on the scales on the Sunday before the group, I actually gained a pound. So that was 1 pound up, and then I made a decision. I spoke to my consultant Zoe, and I spoke to my group members, and as just because I was putting myself, I thought anyway, I was putting myself under a lot of stress, a lot of pressure, and at these crazy times, that because of the way my health is. Because I was putting myself under a lot of pressure, and because my leg isn't great and stuff like that, and I was kind of putting myself under a little bit of pressure, I just realised after talking to Zoe and talking to my group members and actually doing a few other different things to see, you know, where I am on my journey, I decided, which was a big decision for me with Slimming World, was that instead of at this time at moment, because I can't do a lot of different things, instead of having my target at 6.5 stone, I'd actually basically just move my target back up to my 6 stone award, just to take that pressure off and just to be a little bit more kinder to myself instead of beating myself up about things. Because I try not to beat myself up about things, and I think when I started these videos, I was saying to all you guys, you know, try and think positive set of different things and not to beat yourselves up. But I just noticed that recently I was actually starting to beat myself up a bit more. So I decided, I took the big chance, and I took the big decision of going, okay, Alan, move your target back up to 6 stone, which means I have about, like, I think about four to five, I think it's about 4 pounds to lose to get back into target, around that. And I just think it takes the pressure off at this moment. And as I said to my consultant Zoe and my group members, when I get to my target again of the 6 stone award, which I want to do and I want to get there, and then when we go back to group, whenever that's going to be, I think we're not at that stage yet with this virus that's out there to go back to group, I don't think, but I'm sure those decisions will be made in the next few weeks or whatever. And so, as I said to my group members and I said to my consultant Zoe, what I'm going to do is, when I get back to group and when I get my Botox, which hopefully I will get, my Botox is now due. I got a new appointment for that for the 30th of June, which, fingers crossed, I will get that Botox and my leg will be feeling much better and stuff like that. So I just made that big decision, to just put my target back to 6 stone. It's a good bit of weight to have lost, and just to take the pressure off me for the time being. So that's the big decision I've come to with Slimming World. So as well, I got weighed in, as I said, this week. I weighed in, and today is the 11th of May. So today, this video, I've recorded this video, and it is Monday the 11th of May. And this week I've lost a pound. So that pound I put on, last week it's come off again, so I'm pretty happy with that. And I think maybe another reason why that's happened is because I've actually taken the pressure off, and I haven't been getting as much beat myself up or getting negative with myself and things like that. So that's one of the decisions that I made. And one thing I decided to do was, as well, before I made the decision to change my target back to the 6 stone award, was that I went back and I looked at some of my old videos, because the reason why I'm doing these videos as well is to give me motivation to record my journey on Slimming World, to share with all of you and stuff like that. But as well, it was when I was setting the challenge to raise the money for the Stroke Association and do these videos. Also, it was to help me with my speech, because of my stroke, sometimes I mumble my words. And as well as that, just to give myself more self-confidence in myself. And so basically, I look back at some of my old videos, and I noticed there was a few little things that I used to say to myself and say to you guys in my old videos. And that was to not beat yourselves up, to be kind to yourself. And as well, one thing that I forgot and I actually stopped doing, there's two things I've actually stopped doing since, as the months have gone by, what doing these videos is, and I'm bringing them back into place, and I'm going to tell you what they are now is. And one of them is that in my old videos, and what I used to do myself every day was, I used to write down 5 things I was proud of, and then I'd kind of write 5 things that I was proud of, and then I'd write down maybe 2 things that I wanted to shoot for my gold for that week, if it was to do an extra hour of body magic, or if it was to make a different meal in Slimming World, if it was going to be an SP meal, or if it's going to be some type of different meal. So basically what I've done was, I've actually gone back to doing those little 5 little kind of messages to myself every day of what I'm proud of and what I'm happy that I've achieved. And I've actually taken some of my old advice from one of my old videos, and that is to be kind to myself and to not put pressure on myself. So I've taken that from my old videos. As well as that, I've brought back, which I don't think I've ever shown on my channel, but I used to have a motivation board, which I still do have, about my journey. And I have loads of different things, motivation sayings and different things that will help me with my journey. And I've taken that back out and I've put it up, and I'm going to use that motivation board to help me get more motivated to get back down to my target, and just to give myself a little bit more motivation, and to basically as well, a little bit of, when I look at the board, to be proud of myself and of how far I've come. And know that, and just kind of remind myself that, you know, things are not going to be, you're not always going to be, have the ups and downs with my disability and stuff like that, and I can overcome that as I did before, and not let it get involved with my Slimming World journey. As well as that, I've like this week I've been messing with the editing program on my video, and I kind of put a little video together that I can look back at myself and whenever I want to get a bit of motivation. So I've done a little bit of a funny video for myself just to look back on. I may share it in this video. If I do, it will be probably at the end. So when I say goodbye for that, I may put the video there and you may get to see it, or maybe at another time I will show you that video. So that's another thing that I have done this week. One more thing that I have done as well, which I've started to do. I've started to do kind of like a little video kind of diary, quick little video diary to myself every day. So I've been doing like a 5 minute kind of Alan motivation kind of video to myself, and I've been just putting them away. So I started doing them about, I think it was like last Thursday. I've been kind of like doing a 5 minute kind of motivation video to myself, and just like to set in the morning time, and it sets me up to do to get on with what I'm gonna do in the day. So I've been kind of doing those type of things. So I kind of, you know, as I said, I've put a lot of things in place. I put my motivation board, it's coming back out. I've changed my target back up to my $6 award. And I'm just doing everything I can do with the help of friends, with the help of my group members, with the help of my lovely consultant Zoe, who's doing a great job on Zoom and stuff. I really love our meetings on Zoom. It's kind of one of those things that I really look forward to each week, seeing my Stimble World group members and seeing Zoe and stuff like that. So she's doing a great job. And yeah, so I just wanted to kind of come on and say hello, guys, and see how yous are doing as well. And I'd love to hear from yous. I'd love to hear from yous and see how yous are getting on your Stimble World journey. Have yous had some ups and downs on your journey at the moment with the lockdown and stuff like that? And I know that things are probably going to be changing with that as the weeks go by or whatever. So just let me know how yous are getting on. I'd love to hear from yous and stuff. I hope yous are having a great week, and I hope that you know, everything's working out well for yous guys. So until next time, be kind to yourself and have a great week. Bye.